that you spent some time in solfege working on rhythms, let's go to hydrogen and check that out. Okay, I'm going up to the menu, applications, multimedia, and in this menu it's called drum machine. And when you point at it, it says hydrogen drum machine. I have to say, I was really pleased when I opened this up. I started using this program in 2005. And, you know, I use it every year with kids. But I hadn't opened this up for a while, and the updates are really great. So when you open into Hydrogen, this is what it looks like. These are the main features. What we have here is this is where we edit the notes, and instead of, okay, so it's like a grid. But essentially, what you see are quarter notes, eighth notes, and sixteenth notes. I think I'm going to turn right now. The resolution it says res right here, 8. I'm going to change that to 16, so we will see little lines for 16th notes as well. The numbers up here are the quarter notes. They're the beat. And we're working just with 4 beats per measure right now. See, this window is 1 measure. And you can change that. You can change it. We're not going to do it right now, but you can change it to be any rhythm pattern you want. It could be 6-8, 2-2. Okay, but we're just doing basic common time 4-4. So 4 beats in a measure, quarter note gets 1 beat. So where the numbers are, those are the quarter notes. Now, halfway in between the numbers are the eighth notes. So this would be an eighth note here. Eighth note, eighth note, eighth note, eighth note. And then the smaller increments that I put in there represent 16th notes. And you notice that for every beat, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 16th notes. This is, they call it the pattern editor. Now up here, this is the song editor, and what's open right currently, it opens right up to a demo. And in fact, that's where we'll spend most of our time. When you first look at it, I'm going to want you to listen to all the demos. But the song editor, see where it says up here, it says main 1, main 2, main 3, it's 1-1, that would be, well, actually, that's just how the person who wrote this has named them. But that, each one of those represents a different pattern that the person has created down here. Okay? And so, here you have, now all these different patterns, you see they are organized. Okay, so here's your first measure, second measure. So they have the song editor, the first pattern in the first measure, the second pattern in the second measure, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, and so you could put these in, you can have them in any arrangement. You could be have more than one playing at a time. Now coming down here, the drum kit is the GM drum kit is what they are using. And so what you see here, okay, so here it says kick, and that's like a bass drum. You see that there is a bass drum on the first beat, okay? And then there is, it's like, okay, if you're counting, if you're in band, you know about this, and you've all heard it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Actually, I'm doing that wrong, aren't I? Okay, I'm sorry. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and if you're counting eighth notes, then you go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And so that makes sense back to what we were doing in solfege. And then for the 16th notes, If you're in band, generally they'd go one eanda, two eanda, three eanda, four eanda. Now, if we were using our cymbals, it would be ta, 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 ti, 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 and tippy, 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 tippy. Okay, so I said all that business to go back to here we have a bass drum, and they have the bass drum is it hits on the first beat and then 2.5, which is the eighth note in between beats 2 and 3, and then also it's on the eighth note here, and we'll hear that in a moment. Okay, so then we have a snare drum. This is going to be very syncopated because as you can, and a syncopation, define that. Okay, so if marching songs aren't syncopated, syncopated rhythms are where you have, it's not just straight 1, 2, 3, 4. You use notes in between, as you can see right here. Who knows? That's kind of like a grace note. That would be a short little note right before the beat. In fact, that must be what that is, a grace note. Okay, so maybe it's not quite as syncopated. They just have some grace notes in here. Okay. But, well, I don't know. Okay, so, you know, marching beats are straight forward. Syncopation is where you have beats in unexpected places. That's my definition. Okay, so the instruments are on the side that they're using. Bass drum, snare drum, there's a hand clap. The hand clap is like the syncopation part. And then hi-hat, those are cymbals that, if you see a drum set, they... it says closed, which means they're sitting there together. It's two cymbals. I'd have to put a picture in here to actually show you. If they're closed, the sound is more dead sounding. If it's open hi-hat, then it's going to ring. You know, it's going to be a sustained tone. Okay, so like I said before, I'm not a band person, so it's kind of a in layman's terms. Okay, so now, so these are the instruments that are currently being used. Now notice there's a bunch of empty ones down here. And on the right-hand side of your screen, you can actually, right here, create your own instrument. Now, I don't know if I'm going to do anything with that, but you're welcome to. But the thing that I do love using is, I'm clicking up here where it says sound library, and this is one of the things that is just fabulous. This is grown since I first used this program, and if you click on any of the plus signs, you're going to find a large list of additional instruments. And then if you come over here and scroll down to one of the empty areas, you know, okay, so here this looks like a cymbal, a cowbell. I'm going to drag that over there. Okay, so here I've added a cowbell to this line. And, okay, and then, oh my goodness gracious. And here's Eastern Hop. That has some, let's look at lo-fi cow. I don't even know what that is. Okay. So anyway, we have the opportunity to add just, I haven't gone through and counted them, but there's got to be a couple hundred different instruments at least there. Okay. So I'm going to play this, and this is GM kit demo number 3. Okay. Okay, now let me show you where the other demos are, because this is the very first thing I'm going to want you to do, is go listen to all the demos. For one thing, so you just go to Project, Open Demo. Do I want to save or discard? I'm gonna just discard the changes because I don't want to save over the top of the demo. Okay, now something you'll notice here, and it's not completely 100% true, but the demos do represent a bunch of the different system drum kits here. So if you listen to a demo, you're going to have the chance to hear some of these. And I actually took one of the demos and I used it in the very first little video you would have watched about good posture. I used, I think I used the first one. Okay, so I'm just going to pick one. Let's go New Jazzy. Let's see what that is. Okay, let's play that one. Starting to repeat, so I'll stop. But okay, so what this person looking at the up here at the song editor, they just have four different patterns. Okay, and you can see for the first three measures, the first pattern repeats. Okay, then when you click on the pattern here, then it changes down here in the pattern editor. Okay, so then they do one measure of the second pattern. Three measures of the third pattern. Okay. They do the fourth pattern just one time, and then they go back to the first pattern again. Okay. So that is your first assignment. Just told you a little bit about it. Okay, well, let me add one more thing. Okay, because you're going to have to play. I want you first to go through and listen to all the demos and pay attention to things. This is going to change. Because you know, the first one, it had one of the GM kit, the drum kit over here. See, that was what was over here. But now it says Milo drums. So when you change to a different demo, it's going to use a different drum set. So pay attention to that. I'm going to show you how to start your own though, and that's an assignment. Is just to simply. Try out a lot of different things, but save one drum pattern that you compose. So we're just going to go Project New. Okay, and all that did is just cleared this away. That's all empty now. Now, whether you want to do more than one pattern, just make sure you do one. Okay. And now if you, let me see, does this work that way? Do I double click? No. Or instruments, tools. Okay, I was just looking at, this is something that I haven't actually, well, let me see. I'm going to try this. I'm going to try just dragging. Does that drag? No. Okay, now I know that you can drag them all over individually. Let's see. Right. Ah, there we go. This is it. Right click, load. Load. And there you go. It changed to the other one. So if you want to change to any of these drum patterns, hip hop one, right click, load. There you go. Now I noticed there was also a right click delete. Be careful you don't do that because you really don't want to get rid of any of your libraries. You never know when you're going to want them. Okay, so just looking at, just here's an example of a simple pattern. Where it says kick, those are bass drums, and so I'm going to put a bass drum on each of the quarter note, each of the beats, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and then I'm going to go put a snare drum on the eighth note in between, so it would be 1 and 2 and 3 and then you got to scroll over, find the 4 and. Okay, let's listen to that. Oh, that's too fast. Okay, I kind of want bum chick, bum chick. So this is, see where it says 120? That is the speed, and I would say I want it much less, maybe half. Okay, let's see. That's still too fast. There you go. Okay. Okay, and so now I'm going to, what do we got down here? I want, let me see, what are you? Yeah, that's all right. Oh, okay, closed hi-hat, C-H-H. Okay, so I am going to put a closed hi-hat beat on every eighth note. You see that? So it's 1 and 2 and T, 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 T. Okay, so. Okay, let's listen to that. That's not very loud, though. Stop. Okay, mixer. Is that going to... Oh, there's the mixer. Okay, I brought up the mixer, and what I'm doing here is I'm taking... Okay, so here are my instruments down here. I am going to make that hi-hat louder because I couldn't hear it. So do you see that CHH1? Okay, I'm going to just move up the volume and close this window. Now let's see if I like that better. I cannot hear that at all. Okay, stop. Okay, I think I'm going to just switch instrument, or I'm going to add them. There, we can have two. I'm going to add, because I want to be able to hear that hi-hat. Maybe, I mean, you know how it is. Some instruments are just simply not as loud as the, as, if you're playing a triangle, you know, the little tiny triangle thing, that metal thing that you just hit with a little metal pencil deal. Okay, that's never going to be very loud. So some instruments simply are just simply not as loud as others. Let's see if that helped. Cow. Okay, stop. How come that does not... Oh, that says open hi-hat. Oh, or am I... Okay. Okay. Do I need 16th notes? That's why. Okay, there you go. That's my mistake. Okay, there we go. That's what I'm looking for. There we go. Okay, now, you know what actually I did that I... Okay. Ah. Okay, I've made this a lot more complicated. I'm going to have to put 32nd notes in here. Okay. Actually, this is what I did. I should have had... this is my mistake. I should have had the bass drum on just 1 and 3 and have the snare drum on 2 and 4 and then have the hi-hat and then I wouldn't have needed to slow it down so much. So that was sort of an error in judgment, but all I did, all I'm going to do now is, okay, so now this does not have... Okay, I need some toms for what I want to do. Okay, there we go. Low tom, high tom. No, I need 3 toms. Okay, I'm just looking through the drum kits because I want some toms. Where are they? There we go. There we go. Okay, Tom low, Tom mid, Tom high. Okay. There, I'm just dragging him over. I guess it doesn't matter where you put him. Okay. That's kind of, can I move it down? Oh yeah. Okay, so da. Okay. And what I wanted to do was, this is going to give the effect. Okay, let's just see what that did. Okay, now, I'm not going to fix it on the little video here, but actually, I would probably scrap this and start all over. I would just go file new, discard that, ugh. Go back to 120, go back and do the thing that I wanted to do. Kick on 1 and 3, snare on 2 and 4. There's the toms, hi-hat on eighth notes. Okay, there we go. There we go. And then actually where I wanted the toms, let me see, 1, 2, 3. I want them before the, so I want them to start here. And 2 and 3. Okay, I want them here. Okay, let's see if that's what I want. There you go. That's what I was trying to do. Okay, there you go. Okay, so you know the teacher makes mistakes too. Well, I mean, it's just all part of the game is playing with it and figuring out what you like. That's what writing music is all about. So, good luck. Phone's ringing. I guess that's my cue.